My name is Collin Ward, and I write and record music under the project name of Zipper Drift. I was in a psychology class, and my teacher started talking about something called observer drift. It's basically when two people start to agree more and more on a certain subject, but I thought the combination of words seemed to like be really fitting with the kind of like feeling of the music I was creating. So I thought it was like, it just seemed to be like a perfect fit. I started taking piano lessons. I think I started when I was about 9. And obviously like right when I started, I didn't necessarily like it that much because I didn't like have any go to lessons. But eventually when I started learning how to play more, I definitely started to realize that I really liked music and playing piano especially. I was, most of what I focused on in my lessons with my teacher was classical music. And I came to really just enjoy listening to classical music and playing it. That was where I was introduced to like playing music and like writing music kind of was when I started with piano. After I finished piano lessons, I kind of just started to expand more. I wanted to learn like different instruments. So I just picked up a guitar and my dad got me a drum set and he got me a bass guitar at like a garage sale. And I basically just started teaching myself and just like taking what I knew from piano and just like that training that I had and just like channeling that into different instruments. That's when I got introduced to a lot of different bands and a lot of different genres. That was probably like, yeah, maybe when I was like around 15, maybe 16 when I was like doing all that and started playing in a cover band. The band I was in before, we were definitely into more kind of like a little more in your face music. We played more like punk and kind of rock music. Once we finished that, I kind of wanted to explore just a different area of music, and I started getting really into a lot of like kind of ambient lo-fi bands. I just kind of wanted to take influences from bands like that and kind of try to channel it into something that's my own. A lot of different things that like influence my style and just like writing and everything. Kind of obviously like with my first album that I put out, it's got kind of this ambient kind of dreamlike sound, which was what I was going for. Kind of nostalgic and about, you know, just like there were a lot of influence from like childhood memories, kind of going back and like just drawing on like fond memories from like being, you know, like 7 or 8 and just being like totally carefree and just like going outside on summer vacation and like catching grasshoppers and like just exploring and having fun. That was definitely like something I wanted to write about. Lots of different bands have influenced my sound, and like my older brother, you know, he'd always be listening to stuff like, you know, Radiohead and like Beck, and introduced and just like showed me a bunch of other like cool bands, and he's like really talented at piano, and me and all my brothers play, and just kind of like having the influence from like family to like go in the direction of music kind of definitely helped a lot. Like my grandma, she paid for my piano lessons, and she really wanted us to play. And my dad plays drums and he's super good, and I always loved like listening to him play. So just like all these like kind of just influences from like family when I was growing up, I'd be around that. It was pretty much different for like every song. I mean, it would just be like maybe walking home from school, and I just like maybe randomly come up with like some lyric that I kind of thought was cool, and I just be kind of like humming it, or just like, you know, randomly like come up with a few chords on a guitar, and just basically like it would just start with one thing, and then I'd record just like I just record that one line, and then just kind of like I would just play it back and forth, and then just like add on to that. So it always just starts with like one thing, like just one little like kind of spark. Once I like kind of expanded on them and I felt like they were getting some good structure, then I would definitely like just try to get, you know, get them finished just as like a chunk, and then go back and just like try to like stylize it and make it a little more unique. I just kind of just go at it and just see what ended up, and just if I liked it, I would keep it, and if I didn't, I would just kind of either try to change it or just start something new. I don't think I bounced any ideas off anyone, actually. I think it was more just kind of insecure. Like, I didn't want to like get shot down like, oh, that's not that good. I was pretty proud with like the final result. Just kind of like knowing that I pretty much like did it everything by myself. From where I started and to like where I am now, like the amount of people that have like been listening to it and have been like contacting me and saying, you know, just like how much they've listened to it and really enjoyed it. That is definitely like at a level that I wasn't expecting. City Pages and like NME have picked it up, and it's just been kind of crazy, like more like the international, just like links from people here that have, here and there that have like picked it up and have heard it and have been sharing it with other people and just like said they just really, really enjoy it. And that's something I definitely am kind of surprised by. One challenge is kind of, well, for me, I guess, would be just maybe kind of like a lack of confidence. You know, if someone hasn't told you like, oh man, you know, this, I've heard this is really good, like what you're doing is awesome. I mean, having just like that kind of like a little lack of confidence that like what you're doing is actually as good as you want it to be. Because initially, actually, when I started recording by myself, I actually wasn't planning on like putting any music online or to public. I was just gonna maybe put it on YouTube at the most and just kind of show it to friends and family, just kind of, because I was just writing for myself. I wasn't like trying to write to, you know, get some huge record deal or anything. It's been a pretty good response, so that's definitely kind of helped with kind of like the holding back that I've kind of done. So that's been kind of one thing that I've kind of had to get over, I guess. If it gets to a point where I'm working on something, if I'm kind of just like in a bad mood, if I'm stressed, that's when I kind of just like take a step back and kind of maybe take a break. Because if I start getting like stressed about it, I feel like it's the end result is never as good. So I'll like, you know, if I'm recording something and it isn't turning out and I'm kind of just getting stressed, I'll just kind of like take a step back and just kind of not worry about it and just like kind of let it sit and just kind of go do something else and just not really worry about it for a while and then come back to it when I'm kind of just, you know, refreshed and kind of ready to kind of just work on something. Because it's like, it's not like music is my life and I need to like, you know, get this done. And it's because like when it gets to that point, I kind of just feel like it's kind of not, you know, it's not really worth it. So it's kind of more just about making sure that while I'm doing it, it's, you know, it's always just positive and it's always something that I'm enjoying doing and it's not consuming my life. To me, it's more just about like passion for music, always making it, you know, making something better. That's definitely like my drive and like my aim with my music project for sure. Working on making my music better, kind of like personally making sure that I can continue to like progress with like my playing and like recording and just like any goals I would have more to do with just making better music. In several years, I could see myself really just pretty much keep doing exactly what I'm doing now, and but whatever happens to come along and just kind of, you know, just pick that up and just, you know, ride with it and see what happens. Don't really worry about necessarily like the big picture, like where you, what you want it all to like wrap up and end up being. Just kind of like, just worry about one thing at a time, one little thing at a time. Like if you need this, or if you need to adjust that, don't worry about necessarily making mistakes. Don't worry about, you know, pleasing other people necessarily, or trying to make a big name for yourself or anything. Just have fun.